Part 2. Azure Moon. Blue Sea Moon. The Imperial Fortress. When Claude steps down as its leader, the Lester Alliance disbands, and its lords swear fealty to the Holy Kingdom of Fargus. The chaos in the kingdom begins to dissipate as the people unite under Dimitri's rule. Riding this momentum, the Kingdom Army prepares to march south for a decisive battle against Imperial forces.
We will finally have our decisive battle with the Empire this month.
The Eastern Lords are in the process of consolidating all of the troops within the entire kingdom. In addition, ever since Arian Rhodes' liberation, the Western Lords have been declaring their fealty, one after another.
Affairs within the kingdom have calmed down considerably, and we even managed to win over the Alliance.
Although it was a rough go at first, I'm starting to feel like we could actually win this. That's true. Thinking back on it now, we've really come a long way.
We even have a lead as to where Rhea is located. It is as we predicted all along. If we are to rescue Rhea, then we must defeat the Emperor. If we're going to march from the monastery to Inbar, then we'll have to cross the Great Bridge of Murden again, right?
Yes, I believe so. As we have gained the Alliance's support, we should not have any trouble this time. After the bridge, we can cross Gronder Field and head south. And then we'll take Mercius, the so-called impregnable fortress that towers on the other side.
Fort Mercius, I know of it. They say it rivals even Arian Road.
Count Burgles, the Empire's Minister of Military Affairs, once had troops stationed there. But according to our spies, a large-scale military force has entered the stronghold. Perhaps they are gathering soldiers from various regions to compensate for their losses.
If we try to avoid it, those troops will follow us and attack from the rear. It is best for us to handle the situation head-on. Once we take Fort Mercius, Enbar will be within reach. This is the Empire's last chance to stop us from arriving at our goal.
In other words, if we take this fort, then our blades will be at the Emperor's throat in no time.
If this is the last fort between us and them, then the Emperor will likely do everything she can to strengthen its defenses.
I just received a report on that very subject. The one commanding the troops stationed at Fort Mercius is someone we have crossed blades with many times. It is the Death Knight who awaits us there.
The Kingdom Army crosses the Great Bridge of Murden a second time, moving south through Gronder Field. However, in order to reach Enbar, they must first seize the impregnable Fort Mercius.
Fort Mercius, said to rival Arian Road, the Silver Maiden. Perhaps a head-on siege was a foolish plan after all.
No, you're right that it's the only way. I don't think the Death Knight would have fallen for any tricks. Even if they are denied supplies, they could hold a fortress like this for months. And we cannot discount the possibility that they will receive more reinforcements if our siege is delayed.
Yes, my thoughts exactly. Then we have no option but to do the best we can. Say, Professor, in the past, it seemed like the Death Knight took some strange satisfaction from his fights with you. He's an unpredictable opponent, a dangerous one. Please proceed with caution. Of course. You were the heart of the Blue Lions, and the same holds true for the Kingdom Army.
That woman approaches.
They broke through the gates! Guess it's time for an impressive counterattack!
How did I get tangled up in all of this?
You are finally here. Will Death's Scythe claim you? Or will I fall to that sword of yours? And Mercedes, here you are as well.
Thank you.
trample them. All save that woman.
Even though we smashed the main gate, Fort Mercius is still an ironclad fortress. And the enemy commander is the Death Knight. We must not falter in our assault. I now see why they call this keep impregnable. Everywhere you turn is defensive weaponry. We must capture all of those locations as we push forward. If even one of them takes a shot at you, we will be in trouble.
Ready when you are.
What's the plan? All for our future.
I'd be honored.
Do my best.
Leave it to me.
At your service.
What's my strategy?
I am prepared.
I'll cut through.
More fighting.
Push forward and surround them!
I won't falter.
Turn the tides.
Age takes its toll.
Thank you.
pathetic.
Missed.
Next try. I'll end this quickly.
You took me lightly. I shall not stray. Now, I'll revel in my achievement.
Thank you!
Don't bother haunting me.
The situation is dire. The situation is dire.
Prepare yourself!
My duty is your death. More fighting. You saved me.
Do my best. I must keep going. At your service.
cut through. You haven't earned my pity.
I'd be honored.
Leave it to me.
I am prepared.
What's my strategy?
Shall not stray.
Worrisome. They have a leader capable of summoning reinforcements. If we find and strike down that person, we can prevent further interruptions.
Ready when you are.
Me lightly.
Did you have to kill a lot of your friends to get here? 'Cause I'm gonna give this fight everything I've got!
This is for the best, right?
It's way over my head, and I don't really get what's going on between you and Edelgard. I thought for sure you two would come to an understanding, but I guess I was wrong. About me. I always knew losing meant death.
What's the plan?
Next. It was the only way.
Nice form.
Rather not fight, yet avoiding it is more frustrating and fruitless than engaging in the battle itself. Just be careful. It's my duty.
to be done.
I swear it wasn't in vain.
Seems I'm adequately trained.
For greatness.
I hope someday there will be no fighting and we can all just nap the afternoon away.
Thank you.
What's my strategy? Service. I'll do my best.
I'll cut through.
Don't expect forgiveness. One step closer to victory.
I'd be honored. I won't falter.
Just be careful.
Ready when you are.
I am prepared. A threat eliminated.
I had to protect my friends.
Leave it to me.
I owe you one.
What's the plan?
More fighting.
You're a big help. Obvious.
Gonna need you to move!
Burn until we meet again.
You took me lightly.
Not quite. I can do no less.
All for our future.
I sense an improvement.
This is my stage now.
I have no need of you.
I have an idea.
I am prepared.
I'll cut through.
What's my strategy?
I'll do my best.
Ready when you are. I shall not stray. At your service. You saved me. My duty is your death.
Gonna need you to move!
Don't bother haunting me.
There will be no further reinforcements from this side. However, the other side is still in action.
If they call in more reinforcements, we'll be in great danger. We must take down the other commander as well. And fast!
I shall not stray.
Good. Now we should not have to worry about any more reinforcements crashing the party.
What's the plan?
Whatever it takes!
I was just stronger.
Thank you.
Now to apply this knowledge.
Leave it to me.
Stronger now. Whether I kill you or you kill me, I'm looking forward to this.
It's over.
I'd be honored.
You haven't earned my pity. I still need to improve.
Luck wasn't with you. I must admit, I did well.
More fighting.
Thank you. I must keep going.
I won't be deterred! I won't stop here.
How reassuring.
Leave it to me.
The enemy general has been vanquished. Everyone, move to gain control of the keep. Victory is ours. Raise the banner of the knights. May it soar proudly over the impregnable fortress.
Your Highness, our capture of the fortress is complete.
Now the path to the Imperial Capital is finally open to us. Once we have finished cleaning up after the battle, let's have another meeting to discuss our next move. Naturally, but it matters not. Consider this. Once this war is over, the mountain of official business on my plate will be even taller. If I can't handle at least this much, how will I...
Pardon the interruption. We've just received a letter from Margrave Gautier.
Very well. I will read it at once. I see. It seems the conflict within Fargus has at last come to an end.
Yes, Your Highness. Margrave and the other Eastern Lords are at the center of it, and are gathering the Kingdom's military forces even now. They intend to join with the Alliance Army and send troops and supplies to the monastery.
What do you know? My old man is really pulling his weight. Did he seem well?
Yes, as well as can be expected. He has taken himself to bring order back to our troubled territory while His Highness is away.
I am truly in the Margrave's debt. I will be sure to thank him properly at first opportunity. Thank you for the information. Now tell me, did it seem to you that my presence was needed back at the monastery?
Well, I do have a verbal message from the Margrave on the subject.
A verbal message? How strange.
The other day, he arrested one of Viscount Clyman's men. And, well, the prisoner has claimed involvement in the tragedy of Dusker. He has implicated his lord as well.
Go on.
I was told they would be transporting this man to the monastery, along with the troops and supplies. The Margrave said that regardless of the credibility of the man's testimony, how he should be dealt with was your decision alone, Your Highness.
Very well. All that considered, I will return to the monastery at once. Will you come with me, Professor? Thank you.